All right, hey guys, what's going on? Aside Home Theater Dude, got a brand new episode for you today. Today is finally the day we're actually going to do it. I have the Klipsch RF7s and I have the SVS Ultra Towers. Today is finally the day we're going to do a comparison shootout between the two. So it's going to be a very simple test. I'm going to have a microphone. It's going to be placed in one spot. It's not going to move. And then what I'm going to do is, because I will be moving around the room, but the microphone is going to be staying there, so it's going to be connected. And then another thing I'm going to do is I have these and I've measured them out so that they're equidistant from the center channel, so that they're equally spaced in the room. So these have a painter's tape on the bottom that it's kind of like the batting box or the batting area. And then when they're not in, when they're not being tested, they're going to be over here in the penalty box. So they're going to have enough space for these things to breathe. So don't worry about that. And then whenever these things, the only other thing I'm going to change is Odyssey. So whenever I want to normalize it to the same volume for these speakers, so whatever the computer spits out, that's what it's going to spit out. I'm going to show you guys before and after what the actual levels were so that you guys will know that it actually got done. And then another thing I will note that down here, I'm going to be playing the music. I'm going to be doing that in direct. So hopefully all the, you know, all the juice will be going to the towers themselves. And then whenever it goes to a movie, it's going to switch to like Atmos or whatever it is, whatever the native format is. So I really don't have control over that. But the subs aren't going to be connected. The heights aren't going to be connected. The surrounds aren't going to be connected. Nothing's going to be connected except for the towers. So this is going to be a true to possible A-B test that I can do. And then I'll give you guys my recommendations after the fact, after I do this test. So, all right guys, so before I forget, the subs for sub giveaway is still going on. I have a Klipsch SPL120 that I'm giving away worldwide. So not in this video, but I'm gonna leave a link right up here. So if you guys go ahead and look at this video right here, that's the official rules and details for that video. Whenever that video gets 25,000 views, I'm gonna go ahead and open up the giveaway, pick a winner, and then get it on out of the house. So if you guys want a free subwoofer, go ahead and click right up there, and then that's it. Don't worry about anything in this video. This has nothing to do with that video. So make sure you go into that video and comment and do everything that you're supposed to do. And then that way you guys are enrolled to actually win the giveaway. All right, so now let's go ahead and get into the intro.
Thank you.
Alright guys, let's go ahead and recap this video. So today I tested the SVS Ultra Towers versus the Klipsch RF7 Type 3s, and both of these are the company's flagship speakers. And I think this one came out in 2017, that one came out in 2016-ish. I need to double check my facts on that one. But at the time, these things were the best that these companies had to offer. And I really enjoyed actually doing this test. I've actually done this test before, but I didn't film it. And I know exactly the way this test was going to go down, but I wanted to give it its fair chance in my house. And I think that I actually accomplished that today with I kept all the settings the actual same. All the settings were the same. The crossovers were the same. The volumes were the same. The levels were the same. Everything was the same. I went ahead and double checked everything to make sure that there was no issue on anything that actually went on in this. I used the Video Mic Pro Plus, and this thing records 20 hertz all the way up. So it was a really good microphone to use in this actual test, I think. And I used a long enough cable so that if I did want to move around the room with the camera itself, then I didn't disturb what you're actually gonna be hearing. So I know that with the sound test, YouTube compresses the sound. You know, there's all kinds of different things that happen. The microphone can put its, you know, its spin on it. The preamp and the camera can actually put its spin on it. So take this video with a grain of salt. It was basically, I was trying to make it as close as possible to actually be an A-B test. But I mean, if you guys are on the fence, try these things out yourself. Highly recommend it. I mean, if you guys have the cash, I mean, these things aren't cheap. So try to do this on your own. But if you can't, then try to listen to what I'm saying. I honestly try to do the best job I could with this test. And I really think that the outcome was really good. So with this test, I had the Denon 4400. I had the 4400 on negative 10 dB. And I was using my Parasound A31 amplifier, 250 watts of channel. And that one was, I really enjoyed having that Parasound in the house. If you guys haven't checked them out yet, highly recommend it. That thing is a freaking workhorse, and I should be getting the 5-channel amplifier pretty soon. But that thing is 250 watts of channel. First 10 watts are A, and then after that it becomes AB. But the sound that comes out of that thing is just exquisite. It's very, very powerful. And I will say this, it's not necessarily needed with the Klipsch RF7s. You could probably run the Klipsch RF7s off of the Denon. I probably wouldn't recommend it, especially just from the physics side of it. You have two 10.5-inch drivers. Even though they're very efficient as with the entire speaker setup, I would still probably put some external amplification on it. And that's why I have the 250 watts of channel go into both of these. Well, the capability of it at least. So with that, let's go ahead and start talking about the speakers themselves. So how the speakers performed, let's talk about the SVS Ultra Towers first. So we can't get into this without actually talking about the speaker construction. But with the SVS Ultra Towers, they're very unique. They have two 8-inch passive drivers in the base, and they kind of fire outwards. And then on the face of it, whenever it's looking at you, you have two 6.5-inch mid-bass drivers, and those are crossed over at different points. Then you finish that off with a 1-inch tweeter right there in the middle. So with the actual speaker construction, it's kind of set up to give you all of those speaker ranges, and just having this thing in my house over the last year or so, I could definitely attest to it's a very neutral speaker, and it shines in just about any situation. So with the actual performance on that test, let's go ahead and talk about the Logic song. So just real quick on that Logic song, the way it sounded, the bass just filled the room. I had to go ahead and double check to make sure that the actual subwoofers are off, because I unplugged the subwoofers, the mids, the center channel, and all the rest of the speakers in the room. So I had to double check to make sure that the actual subwoofer was off for the test, because I didn't want there to be any misinformation in there. But I went and double checked after I recorded it. The subwoofer was off. The sound that comes through on this thing, it is amazing. It fills the room with bass. It's very clear. And each part of those actual songs that I chose a blues song, I chose a metal song, a hip hop song, and something for the mids, which was Sweet Caroline from Neil Diamond. So I had something chosen for each one of those specific regions on the speaker to see if one outshined the most, one outshined, just basically if there's anything that was gonna be different. So with this one, I noticed that the brass that came in on the Sweet Caroline song, I've never heard, you know, different nuances of that song before, the way it played out, because these are the master files. I use the Tidal app, and if you use the Tidal app and you pay for the subscription and you go to the master files, Basically what that is these are verified files that were from the studio that give you higher than lossless quality. And I tried to play those on every single one of the songs that I did. So I picked those out for a specific reason. And it was just very cool to actually hear the brass and those very quick little different things that were going on in the actual song, because I've never heard those things before. And whenever you start critically listening to something, here's a pro tip. Close your eyes if you're in a showroom or wherever you're at. Close your eyes and then just listen. Because if you take away your vision and you're kind of doing an A-B test, it really helps you isolate what's going on. So it evokes that emotion and that, you know, that response that you can actually link to what you're experiencing. So whenever I did that, I noticed that the song actually sounded really, really great. I really liked the mids on it. The brass was amazing. The strings sounded ridiculous. And that's just it. So with that bass song that I was talking about, bass just fills the room. And I will say something again about the Klipsch in a second, but that first Logic song, the one, I think it was called Still Ballin', that one had a specific lower end threshold. Like it was like very, very fat on the bottom end. So I'm just gonna go ahead and say that. With the metal songs, I've heard that Pantera song a million times. I think it was called 25 Years. And I know that whenever the breakdown's happening, they have that ride that he's hitting, the drummer Vinnie Paul. You actually hear that ride, you don't necessarily hear that ride like you should. I've heard that song a million times. I've heard it in a car. I've heard it, you know, with headphones. I've heard it, you know, in a stereo environment. And for some reason, with that actual song, it kind of seemed like those the ride got lost a little bit in the rest of the actual song. So with that just one part, I will say that's a little caveat I will say to the SVS Ultra Tower. That was one thing I will give it. It's a ding. I didn't necessarily like that one part, but overall I think the speaker performed very well, especially in the movie. Whenever I did that Fast and Furious scene, the prison breakout scene, I've done that one several times. If you guys haven't seen those videos, I've recorded them already. The bass on those things is very, very pronounced. And even if you cut off the subwoofers and just have these running in stereo mode, you could still hear a lot of that thick end bass, but it was just a little less than it was if you actually have it with a full subwoofer setup. But overall, I think the SVS Ultra Towers, they did well. They didn't outshine in any area. Like, it's just a nice, smooth, neutral speaker. There's not like, and when I say outshine, like I'm saying that there's not one specific frequency range that's better than the other. It's just linear all the way through. It's an all around great speaker. And if you guys wanna have that one in your home theater or maybe even for stereo music, it's a great speaker tower. Okay, so I got all that out of the way. Now I'm gonna go ahead and address the Klipsch army out there. I know you guys are fanboys. You guys are really fanatic about your actual Klipsch speakers. And I'm just gonna go ahead and jump into this. No one go ahead and beat me up. But I have the Klipsch RF7 right here. And like I addressed the SVS Ultra Tower, let's talk about the construction. So with the construction on this one, you have two 10 inch ceramitalic drivers, right? Very, very big. And then they're sealed or they're isolated and they have their own rear firing ports. So they're independent of each other. And then on top, you have a 1¾-inch tweeter, which is very, very good. I had the Klipsch RP series and that one was beaming. It was just nauseating. Like if you're playing that thing like anywhere close to reference, you're gonna get ear fatigue very, very quickly. But that has to do with a couple things, room placement, it could be phase issues and a lot of that. But I noticed that with the RF7 series, all that stuff has been almost obliterated. So I will say hats off to these guys. They made an excellent speaker. I really, really like the way that this thing was designed. It looks amazing. It's freaking huge. I mean, look at this thing. So the performance of this thing, it's not just the visual aspects of it. The aesthetics are amazing. The actual performance of it is very, very good as well. So let's talk about the Klipsch RF7 on those songs that I did. So with the songs that I did, I noticed that the overall lower register of bass wasn't necessarily as thick as the SVS Ultra Towers. So saying that, I'm going to talk about the actual, I already talked about the construction, but let's just talk about it from a physics standpoint. I had talked about how the Ultra Towers have, you know, different speakers made for different things. You have two huge 10-inch drivers here, and then one 1¾-inch tweeter. So from a physics aspect, how could it, you know, give you that 100% neutral range of a speaker recreation? There is actually, the way I heard it, The sound profile of it was very, very hot. There's the tweeter was very, very hot. The upper then lower basses. So like, let's go ahead and say this. So from, this is just a general statement, just try to follow along. So with they maybe like the 30 to 50, 60 range, 30 hertz to 60 hertz, it was a lot thicker on the Ultra Tower. And then on the, you know, 60 to 120, it was a lot thicker on the RF7. So being that it was a little more pronounced in that area, it gave you a completely different sound profile. And like I was talking about before, these are the flagship speakers of both of these companies. And even though they were designed around the same time, they cost, you know, somewhere around the same type of cash. That's where all the similarities end. They're completely different speakers. They have 100% different sound profiles. And I'm gonna go ahead and try to address that right now. So this one, whenever I first plugged it in, whenever I first got it, if you guys wanna check that video out, I'll go ahead and leave it right up here. But whenever I first got this one, I noticed that I said it had a ton of bass, but that was whenever I had it on the SVS calibration. So on the SVS calibration, I think it was at like -1 for left and right. And whenever I did the calibration again for the Klipsch, it was at -6 and -5.5, so somewhere around that region. So basically what I was doing is whenever I made that statement, I was running this thing very, very hot. So the bass was coming through a lot, the tweeter was coming through a lot, and it sounded great. But if I were to keep playing it at that volume, maybe even turn it up closer to reference, I may run into some issues of actual beaming and peaking and different things like that. So I'm just gonna go ahead and say that now. Whenever I made that initial observation, that was basically the reason behind it. But this one was a great performer. I really liked the way it sounded. Overall, the like I was just talking about, the lower end of the bass range wasn't necessarily as prominent as the SVS Ultra Tower. It did do its higher range, like I was talking about. It did that exceptionally well. And you'll be able to notice that, hopefully, on that second Logic song that I did, because it was a little higher on the register of those bass effects. So it was actually quick and a little more syncopated, I think. And that's one thing I will say with this one. It's the transients on it just seems a little quicker, and that's just because of that tweeter in there. That's just very efficient, and it gets the sound out very fast, so it just goes right to your ear. So with this one, I really enjoyed the way it sounded with the metal song. It didn't necessarily have that low end like I was talking about, and then somehow on that higher end register, whenever they were doing the actual ride, I heard the ride hit every single time very, very precisely, but it was getting kind of jumbled by the rest of the other effects coming in from the different areas. So the guitar on that one, it's very, very prominent, and then the actual rest of the drums, the cymbals, those were actually being clouded in there as well. So maybe, I'm thinking about this right now as I'm saying it, maybe that actual song wasn't necessarily the best one to do for this actual test, but because it seems like both speakers had problems with that actual song. But besides that, the bass was actually really good on the hip-hop songs. It wasn't as fat like I was talking about with the SVS Ultra Towers. And on the horns on Sweet Caroline, the warm sound, it sounded really, really good, but overall, it just seemed like there was just something missing. So like I was just talking about originally, the sound profile on this thing is 100% different than the SVS Ultra Tower. So I don't like doing these comparisons because it seems like someone's gonna get their feelings hurt either way. So, because there's fans on both sides of the fence. So with this one, the sound profile on it, it seems like it's very thick in that upper to high end frequencies. And then it kind of just dips off a little bit in the mids, and then on the lows, it comes back in again. So it doesn't have the low lows, it has a decent amount of lows, and then in the middle, it just seemed like the response was, it just wasn't there for me. So I'm sorry, Klipsch Army, that's just the way I feel. I know you guys are probably gonna go ahead and unsubscribe and attack me in the comments, it's just the way it is. If you guys have a different opinion, have an open mind and then do this test yourselves. That's basically all I can say. Okay, so I'm not dogging on the Klipsch RF7. So with the Klipsch RF7, really like this speaker. I mean, it's a vast improvement over the Klipsch RP series. They have, you know, all kinds of different speakers. They have the Forte, they have the K-Horns, they have the Jubilees, all those things don't necessarily work out in a home theater environment. And that's basically where my wheelhouse is. But with these, they would go great with a record player. If you have a really nice old tube amp or something like that, these actually do exceptionally well in home theater, especially if you have like those action movies that you really like to watch. That tweeter does a very great job of the fast type of response with those high-end type of effects, like if you have glass breaking or like a really quick explosion, or, you know, like, just think about this, like if you step on ice on a lake and you hear that quick little cracking and stuff like that, I think this one would do exceptionally well in that type of situation. So I really like these things. Sadly, I'm gonna go ahead and sell them. So sorry guys, if you guys want a set of these, I got them and I have the boxes. Everything is 100% with them and I'm just gonna go ahead and sell them. So keep your eyes pinned on that pinned comment, because if I sell these things, then I'm not gonna offer them anymore. So please don't hassle me in the actual comments. But yeah, guys, that was the end of this video. Hope you guys found it informative. It was a long time coming, and the outcome may not be as popular as you guys would have wished, but it's just the way it is, guys. I try to keep an open mind, and I did keep an open mind. Whenever I tested these things, I try to keep it as 100% true to you guys as possible, because I don't benefit from this stuff at all. Like, what does it benefit me from saying that one's better than the other one, you know? Like, it doesn't do anything. So test these things out yourselves and see if you guys like them. And that's basically all I can say. So I know you guys come to me a lot, because in a lot of the situations, these things are very expensive and you can't, you know, necessarily buy both yourself. So if you guys really like the way I did this video, I tried to do it as 100% as best as possible. So go ahead and give me a big thumbs up. Make sure you comment down below. And if you guys want to buy any of this stuff, just don't hesitate to ask. I'm a SVS affiliate, Worldwide Stereo affiliate, and they do Klipsch as well. Emotiva, as well as Amazon. So I really appreciate it, guys, and thanks for watching. I'll go ahead and catch you guys on the next one.